Hi everyone, I hope you're doing well. So today we're going to talk about gouache, to start painting with gouache. Obviously you need some paint. So I have different tubes. I mostly use two brands. I use the brand Le Frambourgeois and the range that is called Linel. And also this one from Talens. So the two are artist gouache, extra fine, and I really love this brand. I also use some acrylic gouache that I will talk about in another video, but for classic gouache, that's what I use. So I would recommend you to buy your favorite colors first, with also the classic primary colors, red, blue, yellow, and also the real primary colors, light and vibrant yellow, a magenta or some kind of really vibrant pink, and also some cyan, a very vibrant blue. You can also buy some kits, but I actually really like to choose my colors in gouache. So if you can, I would recommend you to do that. But if you want to buy a kit with different tubes and different colors, you can also do that. It's up to you. There is also different types of white. You can buy very opaque and hiding white, like this one. Or you can buy something a little bit more transparent, the permanent white. I think it's interesting to have both, because sometimes you want to use a little bit of white and it's easier with this one, and when you want a lot of white, it's interesting to use this one because you won't need a lot of it. So I think it's nice to have both if you can. The quality of gouache that you can find can vary, and usually you have some stars on the back of the tube and also the series. So the best quality is series 1 with 3 stars for this type of gouache. The color will last longer in time, and also it will be easier to use. You won't have the cracks. Gouache can crack, so if you don't have a good quality of gouache, if you don't use enough water, you can get something that cracks. That's usually why I try to buy better quality of gouache. And also you have to be careful when you use it, to use enough water and apply it like you should. But yeah, I think it's also interesting to know that and to be careful when you're buying gouache. You also need a palette or something. You can also use a plate if you want. That's what I used to do. And apply your gouache on it. You can apply it directly on it, or you can use some plastic on it and then apply your paint. It's easier to wash, but honestly, gouache, it's pretty easy to wash anyway. Sometimes I also use acrylics, and acrylics is a little bit more complicated to wash. So I usually like to do that now. I have a lot of brushes. I would say that my favorite brushes are Raphael, Symbiose. I have different sizes. You can also use them for watercolor. I also really like the Raphael Carrel. Really nice with gouache. And also this one. So they are the Raphael Sepia. They are a little bit more expensive, I think. But they are very good. I think you're supposed to use them with oil paint, but I really like to use them with gouache and also acrylics. The Da Vinci brushes are also really good. I have the top acrylics here and also a Nova Synthetics. And they're really good for acrylics, but also for gouache. So if you want to try this one, they're really cool. As you can use gouache as watercolor, but also acrylics, you can use a lot of different types of brushes with it. It depends on what you want to get and how you want to use the paint. But you can buy a lot of brushes that will work well and suit gouache. You also need some pot, something like that, to put your water in. and also some paper, or you can also paint on canvas. I will talk about painting on canvas on other videos because it's very different, I think, and it's not the best to start with. I think it's better to start with paper, but again, it's very, very up to you. I'm starting on my sketchbook. These are my very first paintings with gouache, and this one was the very, very first. And I loved it right away. Both were on white paper, like the paper of my sketchbook, and here I added a black background, but I painted the flowers on white, on the white of the paper. So they are my very first ones, and then I did a lot of gouache, and finally I did these ones that you can see, that I will show you a little bit more when I will talk about canvas. I think it's really easy to start with a sketchbook, and you can follow and see your improvements. I mostly paint on canvas now with gouache because I love how I can use gouache on the canvas. So I will show you that, definitely, I need to show you that. And you can also paint on black paper. I also have this sketchbook that is with black paper. Very interesting to paint on black. Your background is different, and I feel like you, I don't know, it's like you're shaping with the paper, so I really like that. You can also buy some colorful paper, and I also have this sketchbook that is a little bit more colorful. It's not white, it's not brown, but it's in between. The paper is not that thick, but you can still use gouache on it if you maybe use it on only one side of the paper. So it's also interesting to paint on colorful papers. I think that's all for this first video about gouache. I just wanted to show you what I use and what you need to start painting with gouache. You don't really need much, you just really need paint. So I showed you different colors, but you don't need to have all these colors. You can just start with 2 or 3 and then add more colors. Also need some brushes. You don't need to have all the brushes I showed you to, again, try and see how the paint reacts and if you like the paint and how you can use it. And yeah, also you can paint on your sketchbook, so you don't need to buy specific paper, or you don't need to buy canvas to start painting with gouache. So yeah, just try, just start with the bare minimum and then add more things and try different things. You don't need much to start, so please start and have fun. If you try gouache, let me know what you think of it, and let me know what you like to use. Do you like to use watercolor? Do you like to use gouache? Have you ever tried gouache? And do you want to try gouache? Also, if you have any ideas for the next videos, I would love to know. I also have a hashtag that is paint with Ursula. If you want to use it, I would be able to see your paintings on Instagram, and I would be able to share them in my stories. So please use it, and I would love to know what you have been creating. Thank you so much, and I hope to see you soon in my next video. Bye!